Welcome to Chris BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to start you down the journey to building out your own data god models. Join the Analytics Rebel Alliance. Fight for data literacy. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Turn on alerts so you don't miss any future missions. First thing we're going to do when it comes to building out our data god models is we're going to prep our environment to make sure that we're ready to bring all this data together in a concise, manageable, supportable way. We don't want to be pulling data and locking up our database, causing problems for the data engineers who are loading it, who are managing it. We want to make sure that we're pulling it all in a consistent, easy to manage and easy to use way. For those purposes, I've created out some sample files for you to get started down this journey. First things first, head out to chreosbi.com, click on the menu and click on the Data God model. Once you're on the Data God model, go to the Data God Datamart preparation and download this file. Inside this zip file, you'll come up with a number of different views that we're going to be using to run against your SQL database. Want to get started working with the SQL database? I've got a great video series out there for you to get started. Here's the install guide. You at least have to have worked through the install guide to move on to these next steps. Once you have the AdventureWorks database installed, you're going to go into SQL Management Server, connect to the database, go to File, Open Files, and browse to the location where you have all scripts I've sent you. We're going to run through these one by one, and I'm going to talk about what each of these views do. The biggest and most important dimension that we had to adjust is our date dimension. Adjusting the date dimension was very important to ensure that we are always showing relevant data. The first thing that you'll see in all of the views that I've created for the AdventureWorks database is all of the connections start with this no lock tooltip on the query. What this does is it ensures that when I'm running a query, it's not locking the database, preventing any other queries from executing or running against it. What this will do is ensure that however many queries I have running at any given point in time, none of them will lock another query. Very important inside your data warehouse or Datamart that you don't create these locks inadvertently inside your system. Now, there are some reasons why you might need them, but for analytics, just don't. All right. The next big thing that's included inside of here is the offset. I wanted my date dimension, all of the dates in my fact table or fact tables and reports to show relevant current information. So I needed to offset the AdventureWorks tab that was set back in 2012, 2013 to make that much more relevant. So I establish an offset in number of days from today that goes backwards in time. The reason I set it by today, this allows me to continuously refresh my database, refresh my AdventureWorks data sets, and always have current information that's running inside of my data god. This is really important, especially if you're building out sample data sets like this, so that you can build out those sample data sets a singular time, put your demo data set or demo reports on top of it, and build your reports from there. After that, I went through and I adjusted all of the relevant fields inside of the data set to move that data forward so that it was relevant and accurate. I didn't want to shift into a current date and then to have the wrong day of the week or the wrong month or quarter and have my reports look confusing and hard to use, right? So these have all been appropriately adjusted. As we look at the fact call center, very much the same thing has happened. We establish the no lock, we establish a common offset, and then we offset the date and we offset the date key again so that everything shifts forward as we'd expect. Fact currency rate is the same setup, no lock, offset, set the date, adjust the key. Fact finance is the same, no lock, offset, set the date, set the key. Each time we open one of these up, review this so that you understand what's going on inside of the query, and then run this object to create it. Once it's created, you'll see that you can't run this over again. You'll get an error. If you ever wanted to add your own custom flavor into this, all you do is change the create to an alter. Right, so create. It'll fail. Fail, there's already an object with that name. If I change it to alter, it runs successfully. As I look at fact internet sales, I see the same thing. I see my no lock. I see my offset. But here's something tricky. Is I have my dates are all being offset. I've got my order date offset, my due date, and my ship date. Now, I'm commonly offsetting all of these values by the due date offset. Okay. Due date was determined to be the furthest out. And so that's what we're offsetting our values by. Same thing is then done, but for the keys on the table, so that they have the exact same offset. Factory seller sales is the same. No lock, offset, date offset, key offsets. Back sales quota is the same. No lock, offset, date offset, date key offset, but then we also have a calendar year offset. So I had to adjust the calendar year for the fact sales quota. Fact survey response is the same. No lock, offset, date offset, key offset. New fact currency rate is the same. No lock, offset, date offset. The report employee reseller sales query is a common query you'll find that is used to support detail level reporting in paginated reports, business objects, or other detail level reports. This type of a query is very common to include business logic, a main table that it's pulling from, and then many joins on that table. In order to make my reporting consistent across different environments or different reports to be able to leverage the same query, and I could change my queries only in one place, I'm creating a view inside of my database so that my queries can hit this view. Once you've executed all of these views, you'll see they're all available inside the views section under AdventureWorks DW 2019. You're now ready to begin building out your own Data God model. I hope you found that interesting. I hope you find these views helpful. These are going to be very important for you as we continue to go on and build out the Data God model. Thank you very much. I hope you like this content. Please, if you did enjoy this, like, subscribe, heck, turn on that alarm bell, let your friends know, you know, about this content, share it around. This is going to be a true masterclass in how you build out a data model, leveraging some of the most basic and most complex techniques that are available inside of tabular models. I hope you enjoy this. Thank you guys very much. Peace.